why would you ever remove your submandibular gland? And if you did, how quickly do you recover? And why would you even consider to do it? Here's our gorgeous patient. You can see before and afterwards at 4 days, and then we'll take her away. Here is a parotid gland, which is up here. Here is the submandibular gland, which is down here. As we age, this can drop down and significantly affect that beautiful jawline that we're all looking for. If the assessment is made that it is optimal for improving the jawline aesthetics to remove the lower portion of the gland, you make that evaluation ahead of time, you have that conversation with the patient so that they're fully informed about all the positives and then the potential issues that can come up with it. The biggest issue that comes up with it is, does it cause dry mouth? Research studies have shown less than 1.4% of patients have this issue. The majority of patients that have this gland impacting their aesthetics are not going to see a dramatic improvement unless you remove it. So now here's this patient at 1 month afterwards, and look at her incredible sustained results. Dr. Claytor here, right in Bryn Mawr, Pennsylvania, suburbs of Philadelphia, teaching you about submandibular gland.